Assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh. Just in anticipation of what's going to be a debate on Tuesday morning here in Malaysia between Gabriel Romani and Mahdi Tidjani about red pill theory and Islam. Now, you wouldn't usually have a debate between a religion and some kind of sociological study. But red pill theory is a little bit different. The first clue that red pill theory is, in fact, an ideology or a philosophy is in the name. We all know it's a reference to the movie Matrix and the scene where the character Neo is given a choice between taking a red pill or a blue pill. If he takes the red pill, it will awaken him to the true nature of reality. If he takes the blue pill, he'll be able to continue living a life of illusion. So right away, red pill theory is claiming itself to be the true path of enlightenment and insight, and all other paths are akin to being deaf, dumb, and blind in a perpetual state of sleep. Red pill theory has its own origin story, which happens to be Charles Darwin's Origin of Species, interpreted through the theologians of evolutionary psychology. It has its own creed, including the innate hypergamous nature of all women, which functions as a major pillar of the belief system. In fact, the entire structure of red pill theory rests upon it. The hypergamy of women must be accepted as absolute. Any and all exceptions function only to prove the rule. And it is incumbent upon red pill theory believers to reflect and meditate upon the implications of women's mercenary and hierarchy-climbing nature. The believers have to do this in order to live a conscious life and in a state of purity. The dominance hierarchy, of course, is also a creedal belief in red pill theory. It serves to provide believers with a universal paradigm that explains the natural order and their place in it. They have their prophet saint, Rollo Tomasi, and an assortment of high priests, clergy, preachers, pastors, counselors, and laymen. And like any ideology worth its name, red pill theory has its own sects. The puritanical MGTOW, the renegade pickup artist sages, somewhat Protestant MRAs, and of course the ascetic incels. And obviously, they have their own Satan, feminism. Red pill theory laymen can usually be identified by their tendency to explain the ideology by recommending that you read the doctrinal texts. Aspiring clergy, on the other hand, have generally memorized considerable passages of the texts and will recite it by rote to anyone who will listen, very earnestly trying to inspire you and guide you to the light. Any member of any level of this ideological group, if persistently challenged or contradicted, will generally conclude the exchange by pitying your blindness and lack of faith. But he can always console himself by knowing that you're the one who's living in a state of illusion. Brothers, this is not an academic field of study. It's not science. It's ideology. Genuine sociological fields of study in academia, they don't display the same cult-like tendencies as these people. Know what you're looking at with this red pill theory. It's dangerous. We have nothing to learn from it except to avoid it. Jazakumullahu khairan wa assalamu alaikum.